flames going up in the sky. Flames.
Polish policeman yells in my direction from a porch where some terrified passerbyers are huddling. I run down the empty street. I must get home. I do not have to obey anyone. I saw my father shouting something from the train. I have to be as strong as he is. My mother pushes me down to the cellar. The plaster falls. We are suffocating. Women are sobbing and wailing. After the alert, we see from the windows the first fires in the working class area in the direction of the marketplace. I begin to read the papers. France, England, America. Everyone is sure to help us. We are going to fight to the end. The Nazis will never enter Warsaw. I listened to the mayor's proclamation on the radio. Warsaw will never surrender. My mother is crying. My two brothers are playing together. She and I are sitting in front of the radio. I often put my arms around her as we wait for the news. There is fighting all along the frontier and everything is going badly. My mother, sitting near us, doesn't say a word. I nod uncomprehendingly. Who are these people whose language that I know? Why are they demolishing our lives? And why do they hate? I want to see, know, understand. My mother wants to leave at once. I hugged her to me, spoke to her gently, and kept saying, like my father, that we must hang on. The last I saw of my mother, she was standing between the railroad tracks. My father, his eyes from the train, along with a mouth that kept saying, everything now is in question. And I, as a child, just wanted that.